I want to ask about this because do you have a scuba background? Because you went to an opening of an aquarium in Missouri?
Yes. Yeah. Johnny Morris had opened this beautiful wildlife museum. Johnny Morris is the founder of Bass Pro Shop. Uh-huh. And all of a sudden, George Bush was there, Jimmy Carter. They're like, oh, you want to get in the shark tank? I'm like, no, I don't want to get in the shark tank. And like, no, it'd be really cool. Get in the shark tank with the stingrays and everything else. Next thing you know, I'm diving in this tank. I mean, I literally just showed up to say hello and show my support for the opening of the museum.
And there you are. That's, I guess, a little stingray, right?
Yeah.
Although I don't mean to say little. If I saw that, I'd be terrified.
That's how that guy Steve Irwin died.
Yeah.
He got stabbed by a stingray.
I don't think in an aquarium, though.
You know what? I don't think they're, like, really trainable animals either, you know? Like, hey, this one's not a stinger. That's a stinger right there. That thing on the back? Yeah, that's the one thing that pokes
in the chest. I think they have to go through a really long training before they let him in the aquarium.
Well, anyway, I went there. We're trying to persuade these guys to do this Wahlburger partnership and open restaurants in these Bass Pro Shops because people go there for, like, 6 hours. And, like, yeah, we're really into the idea. But now we're in a tank, and we still don't have Wahlburgers in a Bass Pro Shop.
So this was, you saw this as a business opportunity, it totally backfired.
You see what I do to support my brand, but this is not, it didn't work out quite the way I had hoped, so.
And was it, did it increase the pressure to have two ex-presidents watch you get into a scuba tank?
Oh, they're all sitting there just having hors d'oeuvres and cocktails looking, and I'm basically paying no attention to me whatsoever.
Well, I guess that's the thing is.
And you can't really see out.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm like, I gotta go somewhere else the same day.
Yeah.
And they're like, people just kind of left me. There was one other diver, and they were just like doing these signals. And I'm like, I don't know scuba signals.
Also, you can barely tell it's you, so it's not that exciting to watch. If someone's like, ladies and gentlemen, Mark Wahlberg, you'd be like, that could be anybody.
It could, exactly. Yeah.
You do get, which is very surprising to me because you've been doing this so long and you're so recognizable, but you do get mistaken for one actor more than other actors.
Yes.
You want to tell us who it is?
My fellow Bostonian, Matt Damon.
Yeah.
And by the way, your clip about all the Boston movies was one of the funniest things I've ever
thank
seen.
Thank you.
Much better Boston accent than most of the people in Boston movies, by the way.
I don't think I'm top tier, but I do think I'm better than bottom tier.
It's pretty high.
Yeah.
It's pretty high. So anyway, yeah, he gets recognized, you know, for me, and I get recognized for him, but I never tell people, I never correct anybody. If somebody comes up and says, hey, I loved you in The Bourne, I'm like, thank you, I got another one coming out soon, and I just... keep going. Yeah. It's like when I start explaining, then they want to apologize, they think I'm offended. I'm not offended at all. Not a problem. Thank you very much. I'll see you later.
You shot some of this movie, Daddy's Home 2, in Boston.
Yes.
Is it exciting for you to shoot in Boston?
No.
Okay.
But like random people showing up unannounced and uninvited. No.
Oh, like, right, because you have such...
But I have a long history there. You know, it's nice to be able to see my mom and stuff, but, you know, like... Everybody's like, Will's like, oh, I love Boston. Everybody who, like, went to school to Boston or spent a little time, spent a summer in Nantucket or on the Cape, you know, they love it. You know, if you've been there, you know, there's a reason why you want to... I mean, I love going back, and I appreciate that I can go back. But I have people from my past, some of them kind of sketchy, that'll show up unannounced. Like, my friends were, like, plotting to steal camera equipment before on The Perfect Storm. And they were like, wow, that thing looks expensive. I'm like, yeah, it's like... $250,000. They're like, oh, let's put it in the trunk. I'm like, who are you going to sell a Panavision camera to? You're gonna sell it to George at the store for $500 and a free pizza. He's not gonna be able to use it. They're gonna catch you.
Well, I didn't think of it that way. That makes a lot of sense. Hey, it's always great to see you. Congrats on the film.
Thanks,
just a pleasure.